Hey guys, how's it going? Hope everyone's doing really well out there today. In this video, we're taking a look at another super lightweight dashboard solution called ThinkDashboard. And I've got to say, it's one of the simplest bookmark dashboards that we've seen in a while. It'll be up and running in no time with no YAML files, no databases, just a slick interface and an easy setup. So quick disclaimer before we dive into this, as I've said in other videos, I'm not the developer of this app. So if you've got feature requests or need help troubleshooting something, definitely hit up the project's GitHub page via the link in the video description. But be sure to let me know your thoughts and all of that in the comments section down below, because I'm always curious to know what you guys think. But for the technical stuff, definitely reach out to the devs. Now, we've covered several dashboards on this channel, and this one keeps things minimal, both in setup and in functionality to a certain degree. And I've said more than once that I always like an app that can do one thing really, really well, and this definitely falls into that category. Now, keep in mind, this isn't going to have a lot of the bells and whistles that we've seen in other dashboards. This one keeps things simple, and sometimes I think that's better. So let's take a look at the dashboard that I have set up, and then we'll take a look at how easy it is to get ThinkDashboard up and running. And when you first land on the dashboard, the first thing that you're gonna notice at the top left is the date, along with the name of the page that you're on. And just below that, you'll see different bookmark categories laid out in columns. And right under each category is where you'll actually find your bookmarks for that category. Each bookmark shows the name of the link, and if you enable it, it'll even show you the response time in milliseconds for that service, which is actually pretty cool if you're keeping tabs on your home lab, your favorite sites, or whatever it is you want to keep tabs on. Next to that, you might actually see a letter or two or three or four, however many, and that's your keyboard shortcut. So with just a couple of quick taps on your keyboard, you can launch that shortcut without needing to reach for your mouse. And at first, I wasn't sure how I felt about that feature, but it's definitely growing on me. At the very bottom of the page is an optional search button that allows you to search through the bookmark shortcuts that you've got on your dashboard. At first, I thought this was a search for all of your bookmarks, but then found out that it's just searching the shortcuts that we just talked about. Also, you can click it, but you can also access it by just typing letters on your keyboard. Going back to the top of the page, you'll notice some numbers with your current page highlighted and wrapped in brackets. The numbers that you see here is just the default setup, but you can change it to the page name instead of numbers. And of course, you can click those to swap between the different pages of your bookmarks. And beside those numbers, at least in this case, you'll see a config link. And that's the link that will let you edit your dashboard right in the browser, which means no messing with YAML files or editing config files in a text editor. And I think, at least for right now, that's how I prefer to do things. So obviously, clicking the config link will open the config page. And when you get there, you'll see some tabs loaded across the top of the config page. So let's talk about those for just a minute. The general tab lets you change the theme, the language, columns per page, font size, and toggle a bunch of features like opening links to new tabs, hiding or showing the date, and pinging your bookmarks for status checks. Next up in that nav bar is pages, and here is where you'll create, edit, or even delete entire pages for your dashboard. And these are super handy for categorizing your bookmarks. Maybe you've got bookmarks for work in one tab, and you've got links for your home lab in another. Basically, you can build as many pages as you need to categorize your bookmarks. After pages, we've got categories. And as you'd expect, you can create and edit categories for each page using a simple dropdown to select which pages categories you want to tweak. And last, but definitely not least, is bookmarks. Here, you'll use the dropdown at the top to pick which page you're editing, and then just start filling in your bookmarks. You'll add a name, a URL, assign a shortcut if you want to, pick a category, and tick a box if you want the dashboard to show response times for that service. Honestly, it took me a minute to kind of wrap my head around how the backend works and the way pages and categories interact. But once you've got it figured out, it's all pretty smooth sailing. Overall, I really like how simple the interface on ThinkDashboard is. And again, sometimes simpler is better. So now let's see how easy it is to install Think Dashboard. Now you can run Think Dashboard either via Go or Docker, but as you would expect, we're gonna take a look at this using the Docker method. So make sure that you've got Docker on your system and that you're at least moderately familiar with deploying Docker containers. And here's the Docker Compose that we're going to use. This is actually a very straightforward Docker Compose. It'll pull the latest Think Dashboard image from the GitHub container registry and run it by default on port 8080. If you're already using that port, only change the first number of the port, the one before the colon, to something else. But be sure to leave the 8080 after the colon alone. That second value always matches what the app expects to see inside the container, and if you change it, things just won't work properly. Be sure to mount the data volume to wherever you store your Docker container information. Deploy it however you like, whether it's command line or portainer, dockage, whatever works for you. And once it's up and running, you can just go to your Docker server's IP address and use the port you set in your Docker Compose file. You'll be greeted with a dashboard, and then you can start adding your bookmarks. Now, one last thing that I want to bring up is that at the time of recording this video, there's no built-in authentication on Think Dashboard. So probably don't expose this directly to the internet unless you've got your own security set up in place. Keep it on your local network or behind a proxy with authentication if you do happen to need remote access. And really, that's it. Think Dashboard is super easy to set up and manage once you get your pages and categories sorted. So I think with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. Be sure to hit the like button if you found this video useful and subscribe if you haven't already. I wanna thank you guys for spending a few minutes of your day with me here today. And I'll talk to you in the next video.